Cowboy Bebop is one of the greatest anime adaptations of all time. This is one of the first major post-Evangelion titles, which is set in 2071 when space has become a futuristic version of the Wild West and follows the story of Spike Spiegel, a bounty hunter, and his gang. As its own title says, Cowboy, which is a reference to the American Wild West, and Bebop, a reference to the American jazz movement of the mid-1940s. Its original run was in 1998 and it was composed of 26 30-minute episodes, which was the usual format at the time. The adaptation was a major hit and was praised by both critics and fans around the world. Only 12 episodes were publicly aired though. This is because of its many controversial topics. 3 years later, in 2001, the IP got a movie, also an anime format titled Cowboy Bebop Knocking on Heaven's Door, or Cowboy Bebop the Movie. This film did not disappoint and got mostly favorable reviews, although critics score aggregator Rotten Tomatoes rated the movie on 70%. In 2004, the magazine Newstype USA conducted a poll among readers and ranked Cowboy Bebop as the second best anime adaptation of all times, only behind Neon Genesis Evangelion, and followed by Inuyasha, Rurouni Kenshin, and Trigon. This is how important this title is for millennials. The purpose of this video is to go over everything that we know so far on Cowboy Bebop's live-action adaptation production, and thus taking you, my dear viewer, up to date. Who are the people behind the project, its cast, and how events develop will be the main focus of this video. Ready? Let's begin! In June 6, 2017, Variety reported that Cowboy Bebop live-action adaptation was on the works by Tomorrow Studios, which is a partnership between ITV Studios and Martin Alderstein. ITV Studios is a British production distribution firm. It has multiple subsidiaries, among them Cycle of Confusion Television Studios, which is known for working on AMC's The Walking Dead and its spin-off Fear the Walking Dead. Another of its subsidiaries is Tomorrow Studios, which is a joint venture with Martin Alderstein, who is a big Hollywood producer, most known for his participations on TNT's Snowpiercer and Amazon Prime's Hannah. In the past, he also worked on very well-known titles, such as Prison Break and Teen Wolf. According to Variety, Tomorrow Studios will be working with Sunrise Incorporated, the Japanese producers of the 1999 original anime series, which also is very well known for Yoshiyuki Tomino's Mobile Suit Gundam. By doing so, they will try to keep this live-action version as faithful as they can to the source material. Also, Christopher Joss will be writing the story. Joss was one of the writers for 2017's Taika Waititi's Thor Ragnarok, and more recently he worked on the first season of The Mandalorian, which he wrote episode 6, The Prisoner. Joss's participation will also be confirmed by another article about the show from Deadline. It was also revealed that Midnight Radio, another production company, was involved in the project. Midnight Radio is made of other big-named Hollywood producers that are working on Sony's live-action adaptation of One Punch Man. A bit over a year later, on November 27, 2018, The Hollywood Reporter revealed that Cowboy Bebop's live-action project will be distributed and streamed by Netflix. In this same article, which reminded us how Keanu Reeves almost became Spike Spiegel if 20th Century Fox would have produced a film adaptation over a decade ago, it's revealed how Amazon passed on the project, thus landing on Netflix, which confirmed that would be a TV episode format adaptation with 10 episodes in the first season. Also, it was reported that Shinichiro Watanabe, the original director of the anime adaptation, would be directly involved in the project. On April 2019, Variety reported that Cowboy Bebop main cast was done. The names are John Cho, Mustafa Shakir, Daniela Pineda, and Alex Hassel. John Cho, who worked on the Star Trek reboot, will be playing Spike Spiegel, the main character of the story. Mustafa Shakir, who appeared on Marvel's Luke Cage, will be playing Jet Black, also known as Black Dog, because once he sinks his teeth in, he never lets go. I love that. Daniela Pineda, who participated in the sequel of Jurassic World, will be playing Faye Valentine. Finally, Alex Hassel, who played Translucent in Amazon's The Boys, will be playing Vicious. Later on August, Deadline revealed that Elena Satine from Strange Angel will be playing Julia. The production started on summer 2019 in New Zealand, but early into it, the lead, John Cho, suffered a knee injury on set and needed surgery. Cho was taken back to Los Angeles because of that, as reported by Deadline, thus forcing the filming to stop for at least 7 months. On April 2020, The Observer reported that each of the episodes will be 1 hour long, and a second season is currently being planned, but also reported that due to the worldwide health emergency, it was unclear when the series was set to resume production. In it, there is a short interview done to Jeff Bigner, one of the executive producers of the show, in which he says that they aim to deepen the story of the source material. On May 2020, in a Sci-Fi's exclusive interview with Marty Alderstein, the producer revealed that before Cho's knee injury, they already filmed 6 episodes, from which 3 of them were already done. He revealed that he has already watched the first 2 episodes and had a lot of fun. Sci-Fi also reported that at that time, there was no tentative release date. On September, Deadline reported that the New Zealand government allowed filming to resume. And finally, on March 15, 2021, Daniela Pineda, one of the main actresses, confirmed on her Instagram account that the first season for Cowboy Bebop live-action adaptation has been finished, wrapped up. And here is where we are today. If there are no other major issues, we should be getting season 1 on Netflix this same year. There is little to nothing that we officially know about the story, as all of the hints that we were given by producers, Netflix, and other key people in production is that it's going to be pretty similar to the source material, a jazz-inspired, genre-bended story. Netflix did release a short behind-the-scenes teaser back in 2019. I will be posting the link in the description section down below. So, what do you think? You believe that the live-action adaptation is going to bring justice to the source material, or will be similar to Netflix version of Death Note? Guys, thank you all so much for watching. Remember to like the video if you did, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, join the Discord, the link is in the subscription section down below, and as always, I wish you all a wonderful day.